But you know who's leading? You know who's leading the league in block shots by far? It's not Rudy Gobert. It's Miles Turner. Miles Turner's leading in 71. He's leading all centers in plus minus at 62. And this whole facade about him and that he's not being a good rebounder, he's averaging 12 points and 7 rebounds. He's shooting 39% from three. You know right now, technically, he's shooting better than every single Knick that we have. Every single player. You can name him. He's shooting better than all of them.
I've been calling for this one. There's been two times where I have thrown Mitchell Robinson's name in a trade. This was one of them. The other one was back in the day when I wanted to throw everything we could to move up to get LaMelo Ball in the draft. Now, with the contract for Miles Turner, he has 2 more years, including this year. So I guess this year plus next year at 36, 17 or 18 apiece.
What's good, fellas? Real quick, I want to give some major pushback to this Miles Turner idea. Mm-hmm. This is a terrible idea. The last time a team won the finals with a dominant center, I mean, the closest thing you would have to go back to is like 2011 with Tyson Chandler. Mm-hmm. To waste assets, picks, and players on a center when the Knicks have so many holes to fill, like a small forward and a point guard, would be insane. This team doesn't even have a legitimate small forward yet. You know,
that's true.
So it just doesn't make sense. I understand Miles Turner to me is more of a luxury than a necessity, and he is a good player, but he isn't needed. So I just wanted to throw that out there. Have a good night, guys.
When you look at, you know, Nerlens, Mitch, and Sims, they're more defensive minded centers. They're not guys that are going to get you much offense. Turner will help you space the floor. He is going to help you protect the rim. No, he's not. He's not an all-star by any stretch. We know that. I say pick up the phone and check on the price. I didn't say by any means necessary.
Yeah, exactly. I don't think anyone said that.
As far as the trade rumors, I'm just going to be quite honest. I'm not giving up no young talent for Miles Turner. People might think I'm crazy, but I'm not giving up Obi. I'm not giving up IQ. And why would the Pacers want to trade him inside the Eastern Conference to the Knicks? You know, I really don't see it. And I'm not the biggest fan, you know. I'm more of a Carl Anthony Towns type player. Not saying that he's available, but, you know, I'd rather be patient. I like the young talent. I want to build the young talent. And, you know, I just feel like if it ain't, you know, about draft picks and maybe some players that we don't use, I'm not even making, you know, the call.
You know, Mitchell Robinson doesn't stay healthy. And even when he is healthy, he's a carbon copy of Noel, maybe just a little bit better. Mm-hmm. I'm not investing $20 to $25 million in Mitch and Noel. It's not worth the best way to spend your money that way, especially when he hasn't proven to stay healthy. So I would look to trade Mitch, and that brings me to Miles Turner. Here's the difference, right? I'm down for a Miles Turner trade. Obviously, I'm not trading Obi. I'm not trading IQ. I'm not even trading Grimes. I'm not trading them for Miles Turner, because at the end of the day, you're not going to win a chip regardless, right? But would I trade Mitch, who you're not going to who I wouldn't resign? Would I trade Knox, who I'm not going to resign? Would I trade a first, maybe a couple of second round picks when we have so many picks to get someone like King Dij said, who's versatile, who could protect the rim but also stretch the floor and open up for everyone else? Of course I would. So at the right price, I would trade for Miles Turner at the right price. Mm-hmm. And this takes me to my last and final point. Mm-hmm. That is the difference between rebuilding and tanking. Tanking means you're trying to lose on purpose to get better draft picks. Rebuilding is trying to improve your team without sacrificing your future and stunting your player development. That is the difference.
So what are they doing right now?